Wow, would you look at this? Spectacular. Hey, have we ever got a treat for you this week? We're hunting in the front ranges of the Canadian Rockies along the Clearwater River Valley in western Alberta. This week we're bringing along good friend Jerry Sampson, who's going to accompany me on an elk hunt, and hopefully he'll get the opportunity to take a mule deer. We're out here with Lost Guide Outfitters, and it should be a great week. We've got great weather. Stay tuned. I'm Taylor Wright. Let's get hunting.
If you combine the vast foothills of the Rocky Mountains along with a horseback adventure and add in an Alberta Rocky Mountain elk tag, you have the recipe for making memories that will last a lifetime. Today, Canada in the Rough's Taylor Wright heads out to the Rocky Mountains in western Alberta in pursuit of a Rocky Mountain elk, and joining him will be good friend Jerry Sampson. Due to the vast forest, open meadows, and river valleys of the eastern foothills of the Rocky Mountains, it is ideal habitat for a variety of game species, including bear, white-tailed deer, mule deer, moose, elk, and at the top of the Rocky Mountains, bighorn sheep. Accessing this prime hunting land has some restrictions governed by the province of Alberta. The use of trucks, ATVs, and other motorized vehicles are prohibited in most zones. This allows hunters and nature lovers alike to explore Alberta's wilderness that has been clean and untouched for many years. Sit back and enjoy this horseback adventure as Taylor experiences the pristine Rocky Mountains in western Alberta.
We're here.
Oh,
toughing up.
What a nice little.
Looks great.
Slice of heaven.
Really nice.
Well, we run a tent camp. It's still sort of like roughing it, but it's not bad. We have cots and stoves in all of our tents. We have carpets on the floor, and there's always a good supply of firewood here, so nobody ever gets cold. It's fairly comfortable, actually. We're back in the wilderness quite a ways. We're actually within 6 miles of Banff National Park boundary here, so we're fairly high in the mountains. I've been in this area quite a few years, but pretty much all of my staff that works with me has been here just as long as I have, or maybe even longer. Both Darcy and Johnny are my top guides, and like I say, they've guided for the same outfits that I guided for. It just happened that I'm the one that bought the business. Glenda, my cook, she's been with me from day one since I bought the outfit, and for a backcountry cook, I don't think you could find anybody that does a better job than Glenda does, so we're quite happy with her.
There's 1, 2, 3 right on the flat spot.
There's some, we come down a bit, there's more elk.
They're pretty happy, content yet, but.
We got a bunch of elk over here and a couple mule deer up there and some elk. Okay?
Yeah.
The muleys are just up there.
We're going around this side. I think it's right there, like the face.
think so.
Yeah. There's just a cow and a spike bull up there. Just wait to see if anything else comes with them.
How far is that? About 600?
Yeah, more than that, probably 800 yards. It's a pretty long way.
But we got this other one over here bedded down.
Yeah, there's four cows and a bull laying over here. See, we'll go see what we can see.
He's laying on the top of that ridge.
Yeah, I see him there.
He's 168 yards away.
Yeah.
He's a 6x5, but his 6 points short. He's not legal. He's just not legal.
No.
Doggone it.
Bugle at him, get him to stand up there, Darcy.
You want to get him to stand up looking better?
Yeah.
No. Oh, nice bull.
Oh, yeah. He's just a little bit short, eh?
Yeah, too short.
Yep. Isn't that beautiful? That was worth the walk.
Well, the area we hunt in is it's actually a forest land use zone. Back in mid-80s, the government actually set this area aside that there's to be no development at all in here, and there's no motorized vehicles allowed in the area. So when you do come out here, it's pretty much wilderness experience the way it's always been for hundreds of years, and it's pretty much a high mountain hunt. The elevation here is around 5,500 feet where my camp is, and we're pretty much surrounded by the Rockies wherever you look. We hunt a lot of our elk on the meadows and stuff around camp, as well as up on the grassy slopes on the side hills. We hunt moose here along the riverbeds and further down. There's a few wet areas where there's quite a few moose live. Over the last 10 years or so, there's been a real influx of whitetails in this area, and we've actually taken some really good whitetails out of here in the last little while. At one time, there used to be a lot of mule deer right on the river, but it seems the last few years we've had quite a few wolves pull into the area, and they've kind of driven the mule deer off the river, and there's still a good population of them, but they're mainly a lot higher now. Pretty much have to go up where the sheep are at.
That's cool.
Those are two really decent deer.
That's cool, eh? How quick did they come out?
Out of nowhere.
It could have very easily been an elk, moose, or a mule deer. Come up here and the only thing we don't have is a whitetail tag. You got two awesome whitetail down there. Isn't that nice? That front one's a nice buck, eh?
Gorgeous.
Isn't that nice? Just come out here to get a drink, and now they're just slipping back into the timber. Wow.
Get ready for later. See, maybe we'll find old Eden.
couple of fives. How many elk are there? 17. Look at them, they're fooling around there, chasing each other, fighting. Uh-oh, there it goes now. They keep looking back. This is awesome, Darcy. You have a worse 6-point bull. I can't believe that. Oh, that's awesome. I thought we had. Thirsty, we tried. That's beautiful.
Just not the right out.
Oh my god.
Pretty nice sight there though.
That was awesome, Thirsty.
It was fun. Jerry, did you jump?
Wow. Did you see those elk?
Oh buddy.
I couldn't believe it, man. I just
did you get you see them when you came through?
I came through there and there was a pine tree and I thought I heard a noise and behind the pine tree and he stepped out, he wasn't 15 feet from me.
The bull.
The 5x5. He was standing right there. It was like, oh, look at you.
They came out about 90 yards there and then stood broadside and yeah. I just saw a couple racks.
My heart still just
oh my god. Did you see them all? They were all
Oh yeah, all of them. That's great.
Yeah, they're not too spooked, are they?
No.
Told Thursday good call on last night.
Oh yeah.
Leave them alone. The same bulls.
Yeah. Well, good thing we didn't shoot. This one. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Wow,
a good look at him. My heart was going there. Some people say size doesn't matter. Well, that's wrong in elk hunting because we need 3 inches. 3 inches of antlers and we'd have ourselves an elk.
2 3 yards.
Oh yeah, he's came in for the perfect night. So there with a bunch of cows. That's the same one we saw the other day. That's what separates me from getting my first elk. Right there.
Maybe someday you'll grow into it.
Well, if hunting was anything like fishing, we've had the best week of catch and release hunting you could ever imagine. Since the last night, we've got a herd of cows and a nice bull out there, but still he's only a 5-point. This zone, you have to be a 6-point bull. We just didn't have that to happen this week. We've had a great hunt, we've had great weather, we've had lots of fun. Until the next time, enjoy the greatness of Canada and be proud of your hunting heritage.